Hey everybody, John here from O'Reilly Auto Parts. Today I want to help you answer the question, when should I change my brakes? Because keeping your brake system healthy keeps you and your family safe. There are actually several different factors that determine how quickly brake pads wear out. The type of vehicle, type of use, and the type of pads all make a difference. There are a few common signs that you should pay attention to that may indicate a problem with your brake system. It could be that you've noticed that your vehicle just doesn't stop like it used to. And if you're noticing any of the following symptoms, take a closer look. Or if you're not completely comfortable diagnosing the problem yourself, we would be happy to refer you to a professional technician who can diagnose any brake issue that you may be having. The first warning sign to pay attention to is squealing. Your brakes should really operate with very little to no noise at all. Brake pads have wear indicators that are designed to cause squealing when they're worn down. Be sure to have them checked before the squealing sound turns into a grinding sound. Another problem you may experience is your vehicle pulling to one side or your steering wheel shuddering side to side when you brake. The issue can be a seized or hanging caliper, rotor thickness, or warped rotors. These conditions can cause noise, excessive wear, and poor braking. It's also possible that you find yourself having to push your brake pedal almost all the way to the floor before your brakes engage. That's usually a sign of brake fluid leakage or a bad master cylinder. It could also mean that your rear brake shoes need adjustment. Maybe your brake pedal requires extreme pressure to make the vehicle stop. It could be trouble with your brake booster or damaged brake linings. Finally, if you see the brake warning light on your dash come on, you need to inspect your brake system or have it inspected as soon as possible. All right, having said all that, if you've decided to go ahead and take a look at your own brake pads, here's a quick rundown of what you might find and what it all means. Here is what normal pads should look like, even on both sides without being worn down. In comparison, these pads are also showing even wear, but need to be replaced. The minimum thickness allowed for pads to pass inspection is 1/16 of an inch of friction material. The tapered wear on this set of pads indicates worn out caliper bushings and or worn caliper hardware. You can see this pair is only worn on one side, which means a faulty caliper or a caliper piston hanging. It could also indicate a caliper slide not functioning. The grooved surface wear on these pads indicates that the rotors should be turned or replaced. The chipped surface of these pads indicates excessive heat buildup. A caliper piston is hanging up and creating constant friction. If you see a step like this in the pads, they're not in full contact with the rotor. You'll likely need to replace the guide pins and/or mounting bolt bushings. Lastly, the cracked surface wear on these pads is a result of excessive heat buildup. The caliper or caliper piston is hanging up, creating constant friction. Not only do brake pads have a proper thickness and wear, brake rotors also have a minimum thickness that's necessary in order for them to function properly. Many O'Reilly Auto Parts stores can measure your rotor thickness and resurface rotors if needed. If you discover that you need new brake pads, rotors, or hardware, you can find everything that you need at your local O'Reilly Auto Parts store or O'ReillyAuto.com. Our DIY videos are designed to help answer questions that we get in our stores each and every day. If you found this one helpful, subscribe to our channel to see all the latest, and we'll see you again soon.